Hi everyone, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to reverse a list. That means I need to reverse the elements from the list. So let us say I have input list equal to 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. So these are the some elements I have in the list. After reversing this list, I will need to get these values in the reverse order. Okay. Now let's see how we can write a program in Python. Let's go to PyCharm. Now here, I'll just create a new Python file. And I will name it as reverse a list. Reverse a list. And let's take Python file. Now here, this is my requirement. So I need to provide some input like this and I need to get output like this. This is a reversing a list. So there are two approaches we have. So I'll show you two approaches. The first approach is we can use reverse method directly. So we already have the reverse method in Python. We can do this directly. So for that, what you can do is I will just define a list which contains some values. Let us say my list equal to 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. This is my list which contains some values. After that, I'm just printing my list as it is with all the values. Let's say print, I'll say my list before reverse, right? So here I'll just specify my list. So this will print my list as it is. So after that, I want to reverse my list. So to reverse my list, I can say my list dot reverse. This is a method, my list dot reverse. So this particular method will reverse the list. So after reversing, again, I want to print my list. So again, just use the same statement here, my list after reverse, and again, I'm printing the same list. Now let us execute. So now my list before reverses, these are the element 10 to 15. So after reverse, we got this element 15, 14, 13, 12, 10, 11, and 10. So this is straightforward method. We can just use reverse method to reverse the elements or reverse the elements in the list. This is one approach. Now there is one more approach where we can use slicing operator, or we can say slicing technique. So how we can reverse a list by using slicing technique. So here, let me just comment this. Now, again, I'm redefining this my list and I'm just printing my list before reversing. Now here, I'll apply some slicing technique. Let's see how we can apply a slicing technique. So here, I'll just define one my variable, my list. And here, when I say colon, so it will print all the values. Let's try to print this. So when I say colon, and after colon, this is my list colon. So here basically colon representing the slicing operator. Suppose when I say before and after, starting index, ending index, if I don't specify anything, it will print all the values. So let me save this output in some other list. Let's create one more list called list2 equal to. And after that, I will print list2. Let's say print list2. Now we'll see what's the outcome we will get. So let's say my list2. Okay, just say only colon. It will not reverse anything. It will just print values as it is. Let me run this code and it's printed same values again. So what basically the colon slice will do is we need to pass starting index and ending index. Okay, so suppose when I say here 1 comma 3. Now when I run this code, it will give you from 1 to 3 whatever elements are there. So those elements only will be displayed here. And if I don't specify any starting point, ending point, it will print all the values from the list. So after that, what I will do is from the starting point to ending point, and again, I'll put one more colon. So when I run this code, it prints again the same thing. Now here I'll say minus one. So minus one is representing the reverse order. So from the starting to ending, I want to print in reverse order. So minus one is representing the reverse order. So first colon representing, this is a starting point, let's say this is the ending point. And here this is a step value. We can simply say this is a step value. So when I say only one means it will go and print each and every line one step. When I say minus one means from starting to ending, it will print reverse order. And if you don't spare any starting index, ending index, it will consider all the elements. So that's the meaning of the slicing. Now after slicing, I'm just putting that list again into some other variable, my list2 variable. Now here I will print that. I'm printing. So my list after reverse, my list after reverse. And after reversing this, I'm storing into some other list variable. So that list variable, I'm printing it here. Okay, now let's execute. Right click, run a reverse list. So now we can see this is the original list. And after that, we got the reverse order. Okay, so this is how we can reverse a list of items in two approaches. One is we can use reverse method. The other approach is we can use slicing technique. All right, so that's all for this video, guys. So thanks for watching.